Hey y'all, and welcome. Listen, I know I look a little ridiculous this morning, but I'm in the middle of my routine, and I thought since I have to let these face masks sit for 10 minutes, I would go ahead and film a quick review of a moisturizer that I love. Now, if you've not been here before, I'm an adult, I tend to curse, I'm very opinionated, so if any of that's going to offend you, just go ahead, leave now. Okay, so on my face right now, we have the Jejun Green Tea Eye Gel Patch, right? It's very nice. Those are under my eyes because I have bags. Part of it is genetic, part of it is lack of sleep. And on the rest of my face, I have the Peter Thomas Roth 24 karat gold mask. And I just want you to know I have never paid full price for this because it's like $85. And that's fucking ridiculous for what's in it. But I felt a little bougie this morning. I've had a shit ass couple of weeks. And so I just wanted to kind of pamper myself. And so this morning I'm doing this. So today I want to talk about a moisturizer I finally finished. And it's very underrated. I don't see very much on YouTube about it. And it is a fantastic moisturizer. Doesn't irritate my skin. And it's just chock full of good ingredients. And what I want to talk about today is the e.l.f. Happy Hydration Cream. I'm going to bring that up so you can see it. Back here, over there. Kind of have to look at the screen to see if it's in there. Okay, so this, I think, when I initially purchased it, which was last year, I bought it thinking, okay, because most stuff that I buy here, where I live, very fragranced, very irritating, has stuff it doesn't need in it. And I thought, well, for the price, I think it was around 10 bucks or so. I mean, it was cheap. And I thought, well, you know, I'll try it. And I know hemp in moisturizer, they haven't come back with any studies that it does anything, but it didn't bother me that it's in there and it doesn't bother my skin. So I'm just gonna list off all the goodies that we have in here. We have hemp seed oil. Depends on who you talk to if it's good for your skin or not. As long as it doesn't irritate you, it is an emollient. You've got glycerin, niacinamide, sodium hyaluronate, panthenol, and then you have two ingredients that combined are considered the Matrixyl 3000. You can look that up. It's the palmitoyl tripeptide 1 and tripeptide 7. And basically, I think these are both good. The Matrixyl 3000 is like a powerhouse for anti-aging. I don't know. But there is a lot of stuff in here. There's also, there's a satyral olivate and trehalose. I think that's how you say it. It's probably wrong. I apologize. What I can tell you about the consistency is it is a thick cream. Now, what I can tell you is it's not one of those, what I like to call barrier creams, like a Vaseline, very occlusive. It's not that way with me. I could use this day or night. It left my skin very moisturized, never had any issue. It never interfered with my primer, my foundation, any of the other stuff, so my skincare routine. And I really, really enjoy this. And for the price, what you're getting in it, it's a nice moisturizer. It comes in a jar, which I'm not real fond of. I like the pumps more, but it's a pretty deep jar. I don't know if you can see the depth in that. But for $10, I mean, it is a fantastic moisturizer. I actually don't know what they're selling this for now, and I know that at any local drugstore or major supermarket, they don't sell this. I actually have to order it offline at the e.l.f. website. But if you order like $15 with e.l.f., they tend to throw in free shipping anyway. By the way, bought this myself. I'm not sponsored. This was not free. Not real sure if hemp is going to ever prove to do anything major with skincare, but it doesn't irritate my skin. And it does do a very good job of moisturizing my face, which I completely enjoy. Did not irritate my sensitive skin, which I found amazing, and it has absolutely zero fragrance. Thank you so much, because a lot of the e.l.f. products, okay, forgive that. A lot of the e.l.f. products, as far as their skincare, they tend to put fragrance in, which I find very irritating, and I don't enjoy it. So, what I can tell you is that it's a good moisturizer, and if you have sensitive skin, oily, dry, or combination, I think this might work for you. And for 10 bucks, around $10, I mean, you can't really beat it. And it's, I think that anywhere that sells e.l.f. might sell this. I live in the middle of nowhere in a town of about 3,000 or 4,000 people. So there aren't many huge outlets or stores. So a lot of my stuff I order online, but if you want to try it, it might work out for you. But have any of you all tried the e.l.f. Happy Hydration Cream? If you have, let me know down in the comments. If you haven't, I hope the video helped. Good or bad, let me know down in the comments. And if you, and again, thank you for watching the video. Sorry about the face. It's getting ready to be washed off. We're running up to about the 10-minute mark. I knew that I could get this close to 10 minutes so that I could film it, and then it would process as I was washing it all off. Oh, and by the way, yeah, thanks for watching till the end. If you enjoyed it, thumbs up. If you want to know, you can always subscribe to my channel, but if you want to know when I release new content, hit the notification bell. But what I do with these guys, these little green tea gel ones, which I'll do a review on these eventually, but I just leave these in my fridge, and because I have puffy eyes, nice and cold, slap it on for 10 minutes, reduces the puffiness a little bit. I don't mind it, and I enjoy it more than just cold spoons under my eyes. But it's just me. But yeah, just what's in my craw today is my window unit air conditioning went out yesterday. Yeah. So it's been over 100 degrees for I think like a month now where I live, and so it's like 85 degrees in my house and I'm literally dying. Well, I'm melting, I'm not dying, but it's miserable, and I'm sweaty, and I'm angry and bitchy. And so we're doing what the AC people told us to do, because basically I popped open the cover where the air filter is, and it's just ice all on my condensing coils, or my little water coils, and then on the copper tubing as well. So they told me to turn it off, let it thaw, then run it on fan and not air conditioning, and then see if it dries out, and then try and kick it on and see if it does the same thing. So if it does the same thing, then there's something probably wrong with it that either has to be repaired or I just have to replace it. And then my other one started doing crazy stuff too, so I had to turn it off. So we'll see today if I turn it on and it starts cracking, popping, and exploding, and I don't have an air conditioner again, or if it goes back to working. But I mean, little baby's been working hard. He's been hot. Again, thanks for sticking by or hanging in there and finishing the video. And yeah, I guess I will. Oh, sorry, that was a senior moment thought and then gone. Anywho, y'all be safe out there. Remember to wear your sunscreen, and I guess I'll see you next time. Bye. I do have an attic fan on right now, though. If y'all don't know what those are, Google it. I had to open all my windows in my house overnight because it got down to like 67 degrees. So I blew all the hot air out, excluding me, of course. Oh, I look hilarious. Look, that sucker's sliding down. Did you notice? Those two are actually a different size. They're in the same package, but those two are actually a little different. How this one's a little taller than this one. Yeah, here, I gotta bring it down. It's gotta come off anyway. But yeah, the width of them right there is a little bigger. Who knew?